Hello and welcome to Punchers TV. Here we have two old school mates from St. Leonard's Boys School, all back in the day. We have Jeffrey Lane. We also have Francisco Lewis. Both of these gentlemen are playing in the Senior Games 2024. Hello and welcome.
Thank you.
I know you guys go back way back from your youthful days. Here we have Jeffrey Lane. You know, you can let us know when you first met Francisco Lewis.
I met Francisco Lewis in 1980. I was 15 years old. And I played down through Westbury Road.
Okay. What about you, Miss Lewis?
Too straight.
You remember that encounter between
you? Definitely. We were rivals from teenage days in our tennis, man. We played, we would sneak out of school at lunchtime.
Lunchtime, I got on cemetery and play.
Cemetery, Westbury Cemetery, and play tennis all lunchtime. Let's sneak back in the school.
Okay, that was the only court at that time? The cemetery court, or you had?
No. You had the cemetery court, and you had down by Frankie, right in front of E-House.
Yeah, there was a court.
Oh, there were any courts at St. Leonard's Boys School? Any tennis court?
No, at St. Leonard's School, a long tennis court.
There wasn't a tennis court.
What about your other peers that play raw tennis? Any guys from St. Leonard's that played raw tennis with your guys?
Oh, yeah, we had a guy called James Boyce, Charles Griffith.
Love yourself
We all played together. Back in that day, Charles was the dominant figure. And the guy James from Forest Gap. Jeffrey and myself and James used to play mostly together because Charles was a bit too stiff for us. Mm. You agree?
No, because I knocked you out in 1980 in the junior tournament, guy school at St. Leonard's. The time I play, he beat me too straight when I was a junior champion of Barbados. So although I beat Charlie in the finals and in town, for you to beat me, you had to be real good.
Because for some reason you excel, but maybe you continue to play road tennis, but somehow Francisco, you probably take a different avenue in terms of choices in his life. And your tennis excelled. You were on the tennis circuit as one of the top players.
Yes, please. Mm. I was, after coming from a teenager, I went to the bank storm at semi-final 5 times. But Francisco stopped and he kept on playing. He never did stop. I learned to play in 1978.
What was your reason, Francisco, for...
My reason was stop. I left roller skating, came into play. And then I left the country for a while. So I had stopped playing for over 20 years. Actually, when I came back, I was holding a function at my house, and I went to buy some drinks from a wholesale company in Warren. And I ran into Jeffrey. And Jeffrey's who encouraged me to start back playing. Because he said to me, you know, back in there, if you are continuing to be a top champion, he said, man, you should start back playing. And that's how I started back playing tennis.
Jeffrey then was totally correct, because tonight you played Peter Moore. Who was one of the top players back in the day, probably the number two or number three player.
Number three player back in the early 80s.
He went down to the where?
Tony to one of the 21-1, Peter Moore. Now, Cook Tony, a boxer tournament. To one of the 21-1. So, for you to beat Peter Moore, you had to play real good. Excellent.
All right, tell us, Mr. Lewis, when you start back playing tennis.
I started back playing tennis in 2003.
Yeah, good.
So from then, I haven't stopped since. You know, I started also coaching. Started a club, or a tennis club, an academy. So from there, I want to continue playing, but I can't continue playing at a competition level. It's too much work.
16,
7, 7. Just now. I can get my feet moved at all. My aim is to keep coaching.
Yeah, you're definitely deeply involved in road tennis, not only as a player, as administrator, and you're one of the founding members of the Road Tennis Elite Academy. You just had a major tournament there, which your camp won. You were the defending champion, and you won it again. Tell us what that felt to you.
That was a tremendous win. There was a lot of top teams competing in that particular tournament. To be honest with you, we came in as the underdogs from last year because we were the newest camp on the scene. But we put together a fantastic team. We won last year, came back this year, and we beat. So it's called hard work and teamwork, man.
Team effort.
Yeah, Road Tennis Elite Academy seem to be improving by leaps and bounds. Is there any secret recipe that you guys up there are using, or is it all about management?
Well, it's management per se, and bringing together people who can gel together and work together. So it's about teamwork. Building from the bottom up, the youngsters, the juniors, the women, everybody, and building a rigor. So that hard work, practice, and it's also about a mental. It's a mindset. You know, you work with the minds of the youngsters first to get the condition.
9-7-20 game point a match.
All right, let's look at the future. Jackie Lane, you didn't do too well tonight. You was defeated by Daniel King 2-straight with a south. But what are your future plans for Road Tennis? Are you going to continue to play? Or are you finding that the game is getting too tough? Or it's wearing down your body and so on? Or
man, working and thing too now at my age now, I find it hard to even be writing with them. I gave up in the game.
They said Rahimi, what, you're young?
Little ball, 15. Okay. I fighting out there. I got in 11-1 and 2 in Calgary. 2013 in Calgary at home. So it's telling me that.
It's time to hang up?
Not to hang up. Racket, I was still playing to keep fit, but.
In terms of being competitive and competitive?
Competitive, no, you know, I can't. My feet now hurting me too. Mm-hmm. Most of his left foot, yeah. What friend got pain in his foot?
What's your thought on Daniel King? What are your thoughts on him?
My thoughts on Daniel King, he training morning, noon, and night before, swiping his sand. And when he's working, he's still practicing. He playing in the morning, he hot sand, he come back, lunchtime, and playing too. I don't have that energy that I could play that type of tennis. So he only playing in the night when it gets cold. Now with this heat.
Okay. What about you, Francisco, in terms of the future? You know,
my future in road tennis is to continue coaching. I like I said, I don't have that energy to compete at this level.
All right, ladies and gentlemen.
I can play a master tournament, but there's some masters that are really good that you know that can really come in front of us and the point.
He will have to serve. Gary Summerwood, give the gentleman a round of applause, please.
Road Tennis Elite Academy. Keep working with juniors from age 5 up. Creating champions.
All right, it's good to see two of you guys, you know, your childhood friends, and you're adults now, and that friendship is still there. Is there anything that you would like to tell folks, you know, in terms of keeping gelling and keeping that friendship through the years from boys right up to adulthood?
Respect. I always have respect for Jeffrey Frank.
Yeah, but
seven
to live.
Always have respect. Respect for your friends.
I was saying, then the times, although even the bank junior tournament, he did more hard than me, but the things where he is, so I stop and I continue. Francisco stop and he continue. I play with all kinds of different hard men, and then my tennis just improved for all the years. But people, I was talking with Lenny 90s ago, and Lenny was telling me that I was the most consistent tennis player with an orthodox style in the back tournament. And not only orthodox, I mastered my style. Like, same way I practice, the same way I play tournament, which is I had no chance. So that now that I get older will affect me a little bit, because I can't change to nothing else. I can only play what I know now.
All right, Francisco, I'll allow you to have the closing words.
I really would have wanted Jeff to win tonight, because I would have loved to play him in the final. Just because for all time, all days rivalry, friendship, I would have loved to play him. I told my daughter on the way down in Kerry, I said to her, I really would like Jeff to win tonight. So that we can play in the final together. That would have been a tremendous achievement for both of us. Hi, Jeff.
Yeah. God. That man, you didn't play that. Danny King was around.
No,
that man
no,
didn't
no,
around.
No.
He played back in the 80, 81, 82.
3-7-6.
Yeah. All right, man.
All right, two friends from back in the day.
From back in the 80s. 1980. 1980 was 15. You're about 14.
You're behind.
I'm still playing. Yeah. Now we get old and now, which is very good. Mm. But I have some young boys and we young that was going to them and keep up with it now.
No, 40 years ago.
Yeah, then they stop. Then they stop. So I continue.
The puncher.
But I will never stop with it, because the game is keep you fit and looking fresh. So, but they playing get beat from Raheem and down south. I don't worry about it. because when I was young, told you the same other people. It's just like the land. When the land is young, he runs the old ones. And when you get old, the young ones run. So that's how
that's life. That's the circle of life.
The circle of life, yeah.
All right, thank you very much, gentlemen.
All right, thanks.
For the interview, Punches TV.